guys, I'm Pratibha. Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be showing you guys how I made this beautiful peach organza sari from scratch. I'm gonna be showing you guys how I got the fabric, how I got the lace, how I decided what my blouse should be, and much more. Let's get started. I got this fabric on a very special day. I and my mom were shopping in Ebbets, Hyderabad, and she liked the sari in a boutique. I just bought it right away and gifted it to her. She just loved the sari, and I was really happy because it was the first time I gifted a sari to her with my own salary. After that, we just roamed around in the nearby store, and we went to a store called Sheetal Textiles. It was the first time I actually went to that store, and it was a good discovery. The sari that I bought for my mom was organza sari, and I just loved the fabric of the sari, and I wanted something like that for myself as well. I was just exploring the store and I saw a peach fabric, okay, organza peach fabric. And first of all, it was a pastel color. I love peach. I think peach looks good on me. I asked the guy in the store to show me the fabric. The fabric had embroidery all over it with pearls on it. I instantly liked the fabric and I decided to buy it. It costed me around 2,500 to 3,000 rupees. It was before COVID. So I don't really remember the prices that much, but it was in this range. I got the fabric and I didn't really think much about it. I just thought that maybe I'll put a lace, maybe not, and I'll just wear the sari and that's it. Now, there were so many challenges in completing the sari, and I'll tell you all of those. The first challenge was to find the right lace. I think it's not just this sari. No matter which fabric you buy, finding the right lace is the key to making your sari look beautiful. Or whatever vibe you want to give, right? So I just searched around in a lot of stores and I couldn't find a single lace that would go with the sari. It would just either look bad, or I don't know, I just didn't like any of those. And I literally gave up. I just kept the fabric and didn't just try to complete the sari at all. After that, one day when I was searching for something else in Charminar, I found a store called RR Kasat, and I went to buy some latkans for the lehengas. So I was just exploring the store and I saw that they have laces. To my surprise, they have a huge floor completely for only laces, and the laces were so intricate. They had beautiful designs and whatnot. And the people in the store, they were so helpful. Literally, they searched the entire store to find the right lace for this sari. I thought that maybe, you know, I'll find a good lace. So I just explained them. I showed them the photos of my fabric and I said, you know, I want something like this. And they just searched the entire store just for me, and for a very long time. I think I sat there for an hour or so. They actually found a lace and gave it to me. It was the perfect lace that I could have gotten for this sari. I was just so happy. If they would have said that they're gonna give this to me like for 2,000 rupees also, I would have taken, because it was just the perfect match. I wouldn't get it anywhere else. So I bought that lace from there. I think it costed me somewhere around 500 to 1000 ish somewhere. I don't really remember the exact price, but that was how it was. And the lace was a very good quality. And I thought, okay, all the challenges are done. I got the lace, I got the fabric, and we're good. No. Then I went to a tailor. I gave the fabric, I gave the lace, and I asked them to sew it. They called me back and they said that they can't really sew the lace on the sari using a machine. They have to hand sew it. So I said, okay, go ahead. You can charge extra. I'll give it to you. But then they were like, no. After that, I tried to get the lace sewed to the fabric in multiple stores. Nobody was ready to sew the lace by hand. So finally, my mom actually sewed it by hand and completed the sari. Now, okay, you would think that everything is done, right? But no. there is a problem with the sari. Okay, and this is probably a lesson learned. So when you wear the sari, it looks beautiful, great. And when you sit down, just because you have pearls all over it, the pearls actually poke you from the bottom. That was a mistake. So I should have actually gotten half and half fabric, half the palla piece to be in this fabric, and the rest sari piece could have been a plain organza fabric of the same color. I could have done that. I could have bought a white organza fabric and got it dyed in the same color and, you know, attached it. This is a lesson learned. I mean, if you guys ever buy a fabric of this kind and it has those huge embroidery or things can actually poke you, think about it. You know, it actually hurts. So if you're sitting on a sofa, it might not hurt a lot, but if you literally sit down, maybe on a floor, it's gonna hurt you. Okay, coming to the blouse. Initially, I thought that I'll just get a satin fabric and get the blouse stitched and that's it. But again, color problem. You don't find the right color at all. And yeah, I could always dye it, but I was trying to find the right, you know, the right matched satin fabric. Because if you need to get your fabric dyed, you have to go to the store twice. And I was lazy to go there twice. And luckily, in one of the stores, I actually got a satin fabric very close to the sari's color. And I got it. And I got it stitched. And that's it. My sari was ready. And finally, I got to wear it. It took me, I think, 2 years to complete the sari. But, you know, I love it. I am going to wear it probably, maybe in a birthday party, maybe to office. I don't think it's too flashy. I think it can go good with the office atmosphere in case the office opens. If you guys learned anything from this video, or if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe to my channel. It really means a lot to me, guys. And I'll see you guys again in the next video. Bye bye.